This schematic on Teknic's website shows a ClearPath system with its accessories, required and optional. Each accessory has a small question mark by it. When you click, it shows useful information. This is helpful, but if you want even more detail, keep watching. We're going to discuss each accessory one by one. You can use your own power supply or get one from Teknic. ClearPath fractional horsepower motors will run from 24 to 75 volts DC, but we usually recommend using 75 volts because more voltage gives you more power for the same amount of current, which usually means smaller motors for any given application, saving space and money. Teknic's IPC 75 volt power supplies have been designed for the unique power requirements of motor drives. Among these, high peak power reserve, and the ability to handle regenerated energy. The IPC supplies are available in both a lower power open chassis design and a higher power fully enclosed design. Compared to the open chassis model, the fully enclosed IPC supply has more continuous power, more ability to absorb a motor's regenerated energy, and a finger-safe enclosure to protect against electrical shock and physical damage. The amount of electrical power you need for a ClearPath-driven machine is highly dependent on the exact application and the motor quantities and their sizes. So it's almost impossible to say exactly how much supply power you need for a given application, but here are some helpful hints. From the higher power enclosed supply, you can always run at least one ClearPath motor of any size in any application. And from the lower power open chassis supply, you can almost always run one ClearPath motor of most sizes in most applications. That said, you can usually run any two motors from the higher power supply and two smaller motors from the lower power supply. In machines with smaller motors, and when the motors are used intermittently and/or not at the same time, it's possible to run four motors, or even more in certain cases, from the lower power supply, or six or more from the higher power supply. Given the large number of variables in a multi-axis machine, you'll have to test thoroughly to see how many motors you can reliably connect to one supply. But remember that by the laws of thermodynamics, you can't get more, or even the same, mechanical power out of your motors than the DC electrical power you put in. Both supplies can be run from single-phase 95 to 125 volts AC or single-phase 190 to 250 volts AC, 50 to 60 Hz. For people who want to run off the lower AC voltage range, common when you're first experimenting with a motor at your desk or bench, we offer a pre-wired AC line cable. This cable has an 8-pin Molex MiniFit Junior connector on one end and a standard US 120-volt 3-prong AC plug on the other. If you want to run off the higher line voltage, you can cut off the 3-prong connector and rewire it to your desired high voltage connector. But you must make sure to remove or cut the jumper wire in the Molex connector, or you will damage the power supply. Exactly which supply you'll use in your application will depend on your mechanical power requirements and whether the power supply will be mounted inside the machine's enclosure. When you're developing your machine, however, we recommend you use the fully enclosed supply for maximum power and safety. Next, you need an SC network communication hub. Among other functions, this hub converts USB or high-speed RS-232 from your host CPU into optically isolated signaling. This allows for well over 1,000 commands per second with excellent noise immunity. You can connect any mix of up to four ClearPath DC-powered fractional horsepower motors or AC-powered integral horsepower motors per hub. And you can daisy-chain up to four hubs per COM port, so your system can have 16 motors for every USB or RS-232 port you have available. So, for example, on a host with three COM ports, you could have up to 48 axes of motion. The hubs can be conveniently daisy-chained by plugging them directly together or distributed where you want them by using DB9 male-to-female cables available from Amazon for about $8. To power the communication hub and to maintain communication when you interrupt motor bus power for safety, you need to supply 24 volts DC. This 10-foot cable has a 2-pin Molex MiniFit Junior connector on both ends, so it can be used to daisy chain 24 volt power between two SC hubs, or you can re-terminate one end as needed by your 24 volt power supply. The complete SC communication hub design package is available from Teknic as free open source information in case a 4-axis hub is not ideal for you, or if you want to incorporate the SC hub functionality into your own board. All the software you need to set up your ClearPath SC motors and develop your application is available for free with an unlimited right to copy on Teknic's download page. The ClearView installer includes Windows setup software with diagnostic tools, the ClearPath S Foundation C++ class library, including a .NET interface, and thorough documentation with lots of example code. The ClearView setup program runs on Windows. The class library is available for Windows or Linux. The download contains the entire S Foundation source code package with an OEM-friendly open source license for free. Next, you need a few cables. The first two you can make using tools and components readily available online, from DigiKey, for example. But Teknic also offers these cables if you prefer to get them pre-made or don't want to buy the tools you need to make them. The third, a USB cable, you probably have already, but Teknic offers these too. The first cable, the DC power cable, comes in two different lengths, a 10-foot and a 55-foot. But length is not the only difference. The 10-foot DC power cable has a 4-pin Molex MiniFit Junior connector, overmolded for dust and water resistance, on the end that connects to the motor. And on the other end, it has a 2-pin Molex Saber connector that plugs directly into a Teknic IPC series power supply. You can cut off this connector if you're going to wire to a different power supply. The 55-foot cable is long enough for just about any application, but because it's so long, we expect that most people will cut it down to exactly the length they need. That's why we put 4-pin overmolded motor connectors on both ends, so after you cut it, you'll end up with a second cable of the remaining length for free. Terminate the cut end as needed for your power supply. If you want to connect to a Teknic power supply with this longer cable, you'll need to crimp on a Molex Saber connector. The next cable is the controller cable. It connects ClearPath to your host computer through the SC communication hub. Teknic offers two controller cable options to choose from. The first is a 10-foot cable. It has 8-pin Molex MiniFit Junior connectors on both ends. The connector for the motor end is overmolded for water and dust resistance. The other end has a regular non-overmolded connector that connects to the network hub. The 55-foot cable has overmolded connectors on both ends. If you want to make your own cables, you'll find all the required connector part numbers in the ClearPath user manual, as well as the part numbers for the necessary tools. Don't try to make these cables without the proper tools. You'll almost certainly end up with flaky connections and frustration. The third cable is the USB communications cable. This cable connects your host computer to the SC hub. It's a 10-foot standard USB A to B cable. You probably have one of these cables lying around somewhere, but this cable is nice because it's 10 feet long, which is convenient when you can't easily get the PC close to your machine. It's also a high-quality cable that won't have noise or connector issues. To summarize, you will need a DC power supply between 24 and 75 volts, with enough continuous power for your application and extra peak power if you want fast accelerations, and an AC power cable. A DC power cable to connect ClearPath to your DC power supply, one SC communication hub for every four motors in your system, a user-supplied 24-volt DC power supply providing at least 300 milliamps per hub, and a 24-volt cable per hub, a controller cable to connect your ClearPath motor to the SC communication hub, and a USB A to B cable to connect your host computer to the SC hub. Finally, download the free ClearView and S Foundation installation package. The first optional accessory is the ClearPath Power4-Hub, a board that distributes DC bus power to up to 4 DC input ClearPath motors. You can connect one or two hubs to a single IPC or other power supply, and distribute DC power to up to 4 ClearPath motors from each. This is an easy way to go from 2 motors to as many as 8 on one IPC supply, assuming you have enough power. A power hub also routes user-supplied 24 volts DC into the attached motors. If DC bus power is interrupted, let's say because your machine cuts hazardous AC power upon an emergency stop, the hub will continue to keep the motor's processor awake. ClearPath will continue to keep track of its actual position as well as its commanded position. For each Power4-Hub, you'll need a couple of cables, a PC-SBR-72 DC power cable, which has a Molex Sabre connector on both ends, and a 24-volt DC power cable to connect your user-supplied 24-volt DC power. You'll also still need the DC power cable mentioned earlier, one for each motor, but now it runs from the motor to the power hub instead of directly to the power supply. In summary, in addition to a DC power cable for each motor, you need one each of these two cables for each power hub you use. The same cable part number used for 24-volt power can also be used for brake control and global stop functions. The first SC hub on the USB or serial port can accept a global stop command to stop all motors with one digital signal. It can also automatically control one or two 24-volt brakes, which are sometimes used to hold vertical axes during power-off conditions. Optionally, you can pass digital signals through the SC hub to ClearPath's optically isolated inputs to trigger a position capture, limit torque, or stop motion, for example. For each signal, you'll want to get a digital I/O cable to connect between the SC hub and your signal. 24-volt DC and ground are supplied on this cable by the SC hub for convenient wiring of 24-volt sensors. In case you're wondering how much 24-volt power you'll need to supply, there's a table in the SC user manual you can fill out to calculate the total 24-volt power requirement for your complete system: motors, communication hubs, power hubs, brakes, etc. The other optional accessory is a USB A to micro B cable. With it, you can run your program on the host computer through the SC hub application data channel and use the ClearView application at the same time to monitor a motor through the independent diagnostic data channel. This allows you to collect valuable data about a motor and its mechanics, torque usage, accuracy, etc., while running and without disturbing the normal operation of your application code. This cable is a 10-foot standard USB A to micro B cable. You probably have one of these USB cables lying around too. But again, this cable is nice because it's 10 feet long and it's a high-quality data cable that won't have noise or connector issues. Finally, there's a component you might want to add, but probably shouldn't: a shaft key. Mechanisms are sometimes coupled to motor shafts with a combination of a shaft key and a set screw. This sort of fastening is marginally okay for single-direction constant velocity applications, but with ClearPath's ability to start, stop, and reverse with high power and precision, you want something better. After years of seeing every fastening method under the sun, we've found that modern specialty adhesives, for example Loctite retaining adhesive for cylindrical components, are an excellent solution. Used properly, it holds extremely well, but components can still be easily removed with a heat gun. Clamp-style couplings are also an excellent choice. Contact Teknic for further information, and if you still want to use a key as backup, see the user manual for proper dimensions and tolerances.